Hey everyone, this is Daniel, back with Perspective. Saudi Arabia is a country best known for spreading Wahhabism, which we can see ravaging across the entire Middle East, and a great ally of the United States. Now, until recently, women have been forbidden to drive under any circumstances because, again, Wahhabism, it's a very closed society. So, there is now a new drive for women to be able to drive. In this case, there is a pre-registration period that is happening now that will end on June 24th when the ban against women driving ends. What used to be the case was if you wanted to move a woman from one place to another, you had to be wealthy enough to hire a driver to do it or get a relative of that woman to do so. Now, this is obviously a terrible use of resources. Activists have been campaigning for years to try and lift the ban on women driving. And although the ban is being lifted, the activists that fought for these rights that are now being put in place have, of course, been brought in and celebrated. No, I'm just kidding. They were arrested for being traitors to the country, and now they're sitting in jail. Part of being a traitor of the state is that you must also be colluding with foreign powers against Saudi Arabia, as these people were arrested for being. Now, of course, as we all know, it is in the divine interest of all the Western powers that if they're going to take over a country, to make sure that women drive first. Very much the case. Now, what is still the same? Well, women have to wear exactly what society tells them they have to wear. They can't associate with men that they're not related to. They still need permission to travel if they want to work or if they want to get health care. But they get to drive themselves there now, so that's a start, right? Now, who is this dashing reformer that's all over Western news? Well, it's none other than Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, who has been gushed over by Western press in his last tour throughout the Western countries. Now, what's really interesting about this is, first, the obsession, the true obsession that the news media has with him. They love him. What a reformer. Oh, what a fantastic guy. What a great guy for Saudi Arabia, said Fox News, CNN, and MSN all simultaneously. This same guy, this swell guy, who just culled a huge amount of his own family to consolidate power, who's basically in charge of the Saudi government, and for all we know, a trillionaire, since they don't disclose how much money they've gotten, but Saudi Arabia is very, very, very,
very, very, very, very rich.
The prince, who's also known for culling his family to consolidate his power and doing reforms such as allowing women to drive, he is definitely the neoliberal of his family. A few topical perks. I mean, he might as well be Justin Trudeau. I mean, what a swell guy. I mean, if you listen to the news, again, he is an amazing person who also happens to be a dictator on the side who's trying to reform his people. Blah, 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 blah. Also, a fun note, the Saudi family is a great investor in American products, including a very large stake in companies like Fox News.
We want to say a big hello to all our fans out there, whether you're fixing your breakfast or getting dressed for work or laying in the Lincoln bedroom tweeting with an Egg McMuffin on your chest. Hello!
What's my take on this? Well, you have a crown prince who culls his family, who's still a dictator, who's one of the richest people in the world, who has massive control over U.S. foreign policy due to the oil agreements that we have, in addition to investments made by his family and businesses, again, such as Fox News, who they own a considerable amount in, but also a lot of other countries. We're talking about a combination of a dictator, a complete, utter dictatorship, mixed with the perks of being a multi-billionaire. So you get an idea of what this guy is about and the world that he lives in. This guy is Saudi Arabia for all intents and purposes because he has complete control over how everything acts. His father may still be king, but he is acting in command. And you may say, oh, wow, he got women to drive. That's fantastic. It's a molehill next to a mountain of injustice and beheadings. Saudi Arabia spreads Wahhabism throughout the region, which is a very, very dangerous and militant view on religion. It's not unlike other groups like the KKK. It's just really well-funded. And what happens when you have a really well-funded group is things change. The same things that balance out are different because they're in power. They're not the fringe. They're not people supporting people that are in power. They are the power. Meanwhile, while all this is happening, the U.S. is planning to go to war with Iran, who used to be a secular democracy until, of course, we wanted oil and took it over until that didn't work out. So now we're still going to be allies with the Saudis, who are a brutal dictatorship. It's fun to note, the U.S. is a huge fan of Saudi Arabia. I don't think I mentioned that enough. That we love this country, which has no rights, no freedoms, except for a very small amount of people, where you can be put in jail with no court, no charges, and just beaten to death whenever the prince decides he wants to do so. It is a terrible situation that's happening in Saudi Arabia that has been happening for a long period of time. And most importantly, the U.S. got a great deal on oil, so it was all worth it. I'll see you guys next week.